Hello my dear friends, welcome to RMK Resolution, my YouTube channel. Now in this lecture we are going to discuss about the cell division. Cell division, it is also called as the cell cycle. Now cell cycle, there are two types, mitosis and meiosis. Now let's see, first we'll discuss about the mitosis. Now cell division, why this cell division is necessary for the living organism and what is the importance of this cell division. First we'll try to understand the cell division or cell cycle. Means here there is one cell, and one cell it is rapidly divided into the two cell, that is simply called as the cell division. And in the cell division, two daughter cells are produced. So cell division, first we'll focus on the mitosis. So mitosis takes place in the living organism, especially in the eukaryotic cell, and that mitosis, it is also called as the equational division. So here the chromosome number is maintained. So parent cell and daughter cell, they having a identical chromosome number. This is the important characteristics of the mitosis. And mitosis, it is important for the growth of the organism. So this is a very important process for the eukaryotic organisms. Now in the mitosis there are different phases. So mitosis, broadly it is divided into the two phases. Number one is the interphase, and number two is the mitotic phase. It is also called as the M phase. So this is the interphase, and this one is the M phase of the mitosis. Now this particular M phase, it is divided into the prophase, metaphase, anaphase, telophase and cytokinesis. So these are the further subdivision of the M phase. And this interphase, it is subdivided into the G1, S and G2 phase. So first see about the interphase. So interphase, this is the longest phase of the cell's life, and this is also known as the time between the two mitotic division. And during this particular interphase, the growth material which is required for the cell division is synthesized. That is, the different proteins are synthesized which are required for the DNA replication, required for the separation of the DNA material. So simply, interphase is the preparatory phase, or it is a preparation for the division. So you can see in the figure, these are the types, these are the phases of the cell cycle: G1, G2, G1S and G2. These three phases, it made the interphase, and this one is the M phase or the mitotic phase. Now first we'll focus on the G1 phase. Many books, they given G1 means it is the first gap phase, or it is also called as a growth phase. The proper word is the growth phase. So here in the G1, different proteins which are required for the S phase, it is synthesized in the G1. Then the second phase is the S phase. So S phase, it is also called as the synthesis phase, where the DNA duplication or DNA replication takes place with the help of different enzyme, and one of the main enzyme is the DNA polymerase enzyme. Then the third phase, we can see here, the third phase of the interphase is the G2 phase. So G2 phase, it is also called as a second growth phase or a second gap phase. So here again the different kinds of proteins are synthesized which are required for the M phase. So these particular proteins are synthesized in the G2 phase. Now you can see in the particular diagram there are several checkpoints, my dear friend. Checkpoints are very important. They check whether the all processes they are correctly going on or not. So here there is one checkpoint which are going to check whether the DNA replicated, it is correctly replicated or not. And here there is another checkpoint which are going to check the different kinds of process which is going correctly or not. So there are different checkpoints present at the different phases, and they are going to check whether all the process it is correctly happening or not. And if anything wrong, then that particular cell phase or cell cycle is halted at that particular position. Now the last phase of the cell cycle, it is called as the mitotic phase or mitosis phase also. And that as we already discussed, there are four phases, that is prophase, metaphase, anaphase and telophase. Now we can see here the prophase. This is a diagram of the prophase. So here the prophase, the nucleolus, first nucleolus is disappear and nuclear membrane is broken down. This is a very important characteristics of the prophase. Then the chromosomes during the late prophase, this is another phase. During the late prophase the chromosome become visible, that is the chromosome condensation is started in the late prophase of the cell cycle. Then spindle apparatus is also formed in the late prophase, and these particular spindle apparatus, they are going to attach to the centromere. You can see here, this is the diagram of the chromosomes, they are mentioned here. And these particular chromosomes, these are the sister chromatids, and these sister chromatids, they are held together at the center point, which is called as the centromere. So in the late prophase spindle formation begins, and spindles, they are going to attach to the centromere. Now the second phase of the mitotic phase is the metaphase. Now metaphase, again the very important phase of the cell cycle. Here the nuclear membrane, that is completely broken down, and the duplicated chromosomes, they are aligned at the equatorial position. You can see here in the, this is a particular cell, and in this particular cell all the condensed chromosome, they are aligned at the equatorial position. So this is the important phase of the cell cycle. You can clearly see here during the metaphase the spindle apparatus or spindle form, spindles are formed, spindles are arise from the centrosome, and they are going to attach to the chromosomes. So this is the very important phase of the cell cycle. During the anaphase, this is the third phase, and diploid set of daughter chromosomes, they are separated. So in during the anaphase the chromosomes are segregated equally into the daughter cell. So during the anaphase these particular chromosomes, they are push and pull towards the opposite poles. Chromosomes are pull and push by to the opposite poles of the cell, and that pulling is done by the spindle fiber. So spindle fibers, they are shortening, spindle fiber shortening takes place, and then these particular chromosomes, they are pull to the opposite phase. So this is happening in the anaphase, chromosomes are pull to the opposite. This is the diagram of the early anaphase. And the last phase of the cell cycle is the telophase. So during the telophase, the nuclear membrane is reappear and nucleolus is also reappear during the telophase. And after telophase, there is a cytokinesis. So cytokinesis, this is the final stage of the mitosis, and during the cytokinesis means this is a division of cytoplasm, organelles and nuclear material that is evenly split, and they are going to form a two different cells. So at the end of the mitosis, you can see there are two new cells are produced, and these two cells, they are exactly like of the each other. That is, these particular two daughter cells, they are exactly same by means of the nucleolar material. That is, the DNA is exactly same. That's why, as I said, mitosis, it is the equational division. That is, the chromosome number is maintained in the daughter cell. So again, these are the some pictures. That interface, this is a cell spend most of their time over here, and cell growing and functioning takes place over here. So during the S phase of the cell cycle, DNA replicates. This is the important phase, interface, you can see here. This is the important organelle, centrioles. So in every cell, there is a pair of centrioles are there. So these particular centrioles, they are moving. Centrioles, they are moving to the opposite poles, and then from that centriole, spindle formation is begin. So centriole again, the very important for the cell division. You can see here early prophase of the mitosis. Chromosomes get small. That is, they condense. And centriole, they moving to the opposite pole, and spindle formation is begin. So these are the spindles that is formed during the early prophase. And during the late prophase, nuclear envelope, they disintegrate or they vanish, and spindle formation, spindle fibers, they begins to move towards the chromosome. During the metaphase, all the chromosomes, they are aligned at the equatorial position, and in the anaphase, you can clearly see here these particular two these chromatids that make up the chromosomes move apart and they travel to the opposite end. You can see here in this particular diagram, this is a structure of compact condensed chromosomes at the metaphase, and here this is the centriole. So during the anaphase, there are some proteins present in the centrioles which hold the two sister chromatids together. See, these are the sister chromatids, and these sister chromatids, they are separated during the anaphase. So here there are some proteins at this particular position. There are some proteins which hold the sister chromatids. So during the anaphase, these proteins are broken down. And you can see in the screen, on the screen, the last phase of the cell cycle is the telophase. During the telophase, nuclear envelope is again start reappearing, and the cleavage furrow, you can see here, the cleavage furrow, they get deepen, and division of the cytoplasm takes place. Now see here, my dear friends, M phase or mitotic phase, it is called as the karyokinesis and cytokinesis. So karyokinesis means that it is the division of nucleus, and cytokinesis means it is a division of cytoplasm. So during the cytokinesis, cytoplasm divides, and two cells with identical genetical materials are form and two daughter cells are produced. So why cell division is important? Because we know that all the living things, they are made up of the cells, and the cell is the basic structure and functional unit of the life. That's why cell division is important. And all the cells, we know that they are coming from the pre-existing cell. This is the importance of mitosis. Okay, so in this way the mitosis is finished. I hope all of you watched the video. So please like the video and subscribe my channel RMK Resolution. Thank you. Bye bye.